at number one loading.
We were in love.
underneath. So the reason why this happens is I think when the person made their exclusion zone and applied this kind of gravelly dirt texture, since I run runway follows terrain contours on, that doesn't. So this is a field elevation with runway follows terrain contours off, and they didn't hide it when you turn it on. So it's sunny and clear at the airport and in the hangar, but once you go outside of the airport grounds, you see the real weather. And once you get up to altitude, blowing snow and X-plane is something that they need to work on. The winds out of here are something stupendous, like 230-41 gusting 62. You can see the snow, ice stuff is pretty much horizontal. The bad news bears about where this snow is coming from is those are the mountains I would normally like to be working. Because, right, they're very steep, they're very excellent, and we turn the way the wind would blow us, and we got across literally a pond and get over to some other mountains. So we're probably going to be working this ridge until we get up to about IFR conditions and then be headed over there. So now I need to do a quick airplane change and disable some plugins, and we'll get started here. Just want to kind of show you what we're twerking with. One of the weird things that I found at this airport. Sunny? Not sunny. Sunny in Philadelphia? Not sunny in Philadelphia. So that's kind of what, how I've broken the sim here. I mean, it looks cool, like, not from that altitude. But it just doesn't work, because if you run runway follows terrain contours turns off, there's the skid marks, and now you can see through them. Oops. Anyway, accidents happen. Evil man, don't know, this is X-Plane 10. Not gonna run 11 until it's final. There are enough people streaming 11 and having enough issues that I've decided to skip it. I believe Alan Rush Aerosim Gaming is running it, so I believe he might be streaming as well. So if you want to take a look at some X-Plane 11 hoopla dupla, that's probably the channel that has all of that content. We're going to be doing gliding, though, and I haven't touched gliding in X-Plane 11, nor do I think it would be... It'd be fun to test. It would be fun to test, but if it's going to be a crapshoot like it was when I tested it before, then I don't want to do it. So what happened was the tow plane, instead of following the runway when I tested, the tow plane went off this way. Literally did a 90-degree thing and pulled the glider into the dirt. So that wasn't fun. So that's why we aren't in 11. That's why I knew there was a reason. I knew there was a reason. Let me see why my surface still isn't connecting. The plot thickens. Not Bluetooth. Tablet mode goes off. We'll go ahead and go air parrot. Yep. And reflector. Oh, my title's totally wrong. Alright then, see you, Stealth Bobber. Alright. Well, no, 11's not better than 10. I mean, arguably it's not. Performance-wise, it's not. I mean, if we really want to get technical about X-Plane 11, I don't know why. Oh, I know why you aren't seeing anything, because I'm still in studio mode. be relaxing from time to time. Especially when the winds are this good, like you could fly a 737-200, and as long as you came at the hill with speed, you'd probably get some lift off of it. Alright, there's Spotify. We'll go make sure there's no updates to Spotify. And Spotify installer. And we don't want to listen to Weird Al Yankovic, as enjoyable as that might be for some people. This playlist. Are we going to be listening to, like, white noise? Ah. And Chevy, thank you very much for the non-auto host. Actually, we could probably work this area and get some pretty nice gains off of that. So, thinking about our options here, we do have a motor in this glider, so we could head over to this one and do some gliding. Or we could turn around and try and cut in front of this ridge and be working this ridge up to get some more lift. Both of which are viable options. Let's go ahead and take a look at our gliding distance page. Somewhere, there we go. 30 kilometers an hour, so we have to pitch to, and we could do about 190 nautical miles. That's impressive. 190 nautical miles. Nautical miles. So this isn't the most recent update for his plane. This is, I want to say, 3 or 4 months after it came out. So I'm still running something fairly old. I haven't updated any of his planes yet, because I know he's doing an avionics update to, like, his Pipistrel. And I figured that would come out, and when that came out, I'll re-download the update for this one. But I really haven't visited the org, because I have nothing to purchase. Because I'm saving all my pennies for someday. Let's try it. You know, the worst that happens is we then have to restart here again. So let's head over here. We're going to try and cut in front of this pile of sink. And we're going to try and work this ridge and get some lift off of it. Which might even then allow us to use these and get on top of the, get above the cloud layer. He says, hopefully. Wow, Stealth Bob has left us. Really? Really, Chevy? Wow. I see a reliable Canadian. Uh-oh. No, we were generating lift. And then not anymore. So we're just going to hold on to it. I saw a very interesting thing. Apparently John might be making a new group for everyone to fly in, for all the flight simmers to fly in. I don't know how reliable that source was. Let's see what happens when we do this. There we go. We'll compromise speed here, or altitude for speed. Let's pull those back. Actually, we'll... Yay! There she is again. Ah. How soothing. And watch this. As soon as we get below zero... Haha. And then if we get above zero? Ah. Uh-huh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Let's get this prepared. We're gonna be okay. We should have gotten about 500 more feet. We have power! See we can get off of this. Yep, we're getting some pretty crappy lift. Seems like it was a bad idea. Oh, wait, there's some more. Oh, this is turning problematic. I should get my feet on the pedals, because that's slightly important. Evil Nando, I think I asked you if you did gliding, and I want to say you did say yes. But, I don't recall. 100%. Oh, there's a good Twitch community group. Oh, that's a good one. Chevy, you'll know what I'm talking about. For everyone else, we'll keep it as a little secret until it goes live. And I'm really hoping it does. I've actually been here. I've been to this lake. It looks familiar. Yes, I've hiked the hill here. I've hiked the hill that was here. I do recall it. Great hill. Very nice. Good rocks. I did this in summer, because it clearly wasn't winter. And for those of you guys wondering, are these winter textures or summer? They're summer. Because this would be covered in snow. Normally. Oh yeah, I mean, back when I started streaming, this was one of the things I would do. Just because I saw a lot of, to me, inspirational streamers doing it. And they always had fun, right? So that's the thing. Yeah, we got on the wrong side of that hill. The thing for me is, obviously, you would watch the big-time streamers, and if you saw them having fun doing something, you would want to pick it up, right? And that's kind of the reason why I got into gliding, was I saw a streamer who was inspirational to me at the time, and still is today, Mr. Smith and Senior Stewart, were doing a gliding flight around, and I was like, oh, this aerodynamically looks like a challenge. Also, besides the aerodynamic challenge that it presented itself, it also looked like they were having fun. Which oftentimes, if you get a classic streamer to get into X-Plane and fly a helicopter, they aren't having fun. And since I had fun flying helicopters, like Stuart had fun flying helicopters, I decided, hey, let's try gliding, and ever since then I've enjoyed doing it. We're going to encounter a small issue. Which starts with I and ends with R and has an F in the middle. There it is. I mean, people complain about X-Plane 10 clouds, and well, that's X-Plane 10 clouds right there. Like, this isn't X-Enviro, this isn't Uni's thing that he made. And I'm pretty happy with that layer of hard-to-see-throughness. So, I don't know. We need to be careful here. Now, the issue with gliding in potentially IFR conditions is the IFR part of that statement. The real danger is a glider is not really equipped for IFR, a standard glider. Now, also the issue then becomes, can a glider do IFR work? And the answer will kind of vary. Like, if you're in the right conditions, and a glider can hold altitude and relative speed if it's in enough lift. If it's not, it's going to either lose speed or start losing altitude, which could be a huge problem if you're trying to do an actual IFR flight. So the issue here is either we get to head to the south, where conditions are probably not as good wind-wise, but they're better visibility-wise. So that means we're going to have to work to the south of these ridges, which is down by that mammoth lake over there. Oh, that's bad news bears. See the problem? We got into a whole bunch of sink, and there went most of the altitude we just worked. Even though this hill is on the same lift side as this hill we were just working to get up to that altitude. So we're going to have to head over to the south. We'll try and work these ridges while we're heading over, because those are about the same as these. And we'll see what we can get and head south to blue skies and higher altitudes. Something different. There we go. Look at that. Even though that's the same direction, that peak we were working, I'm sure that if we kept to it, we would have gotten some lift, but I just didn't want to lose everything for a hope when I knew we already had lift here. I mean, maybe it's something in 11, Nando, but this thing, I mean, it's... Yeah, it's sensitive, but when you look at the control surface you're moving, like, you're moving this whole... Whoops, wrong camera view for this. You're moving pretty much this whole bit of the wing surface there, so your roll rate should be pretty substantial, especially at, like, lower speeds. In my opinion, I mean, granted, maybe I'm missing a key aerodynamic aspect of the glider, but when your control surface is that big, it kind of lends itself to good twitchy roll rates. Granted, the vertical stability, it's more stable in a high-performance plane, so I can't complain about that. The reason why I keep looking around when I'm doing this is I'm looking for where our wingtip is. Also, I'm looking for the surroundings around us. So let's say that I come back here and I'm not experiencing lift. I'm going, well, where can I go? So that's why you'll see me kind of sweep my head back and forth. It's not just to whip my hair back and forth. It actually serves a purpose. Now, I should try and redo these in, I don't know, 4 or 5 months. Because then they should have winter images. And this would look proper, especially since this winter shaped up to have some amount of snow up here. That's pretty substantial. Yeah, I mean, this is USA 2, and it's zoom level 17. So, I mean, the stuff I had before was zoom level 18, and the Bing stuff looked a little more wintry than this stuff did, but USA 2 is a crap ton more color accurate than Bing ever was. So I'm hoping that these hills here will give us some lift, because we're about to get into those IFR conditions. You can tell our wingtip is getting relatively close to where those clouds start. Now we're starting to get into the fog. Yep. Let's head over here. So expect some sink. That's going to be given. There's the sink. And we'll reflex up the flaps, which should give us some speed, but do not be appearing to. I don't know if X-Plane actually simulates reflexing flaps. I don't think they do. Yeah, we're fine. It's not like they're going to hear us coming. We're an engineless glider. Oh, there's something loud flying over us. Oh, we've made mistakes. It's too late to turn back now. Up and stowed. 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 Down. 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 Thanks. Well, we can turn it off, but then the issue is we're just kind of going, huh. So, I think he made a fuse for it or something. Yeah, we're going to need some assistance here. Mistakes were made. Let's get away from these mountains, because these mountains aren't helping us at the moment. Right, as you can see, they're predicting the wind is coming this direction, which means that this might actually have been a better way to go. So we're going to head over there for some lift, because all the stuff rolling off of these hills is now sank. Yay for motor gliders. I mean, X-Plane does thermals already, right? So I'm fine with the way they are. I mean, it is, there is the thermal script that he brought, and I mean, I could go in and tweak the thermal settings, but I mean, I enjoy doing it off ridge lift alone, and obviously there are clouds above us, and it's like 32 outside. Do we have an OAT? There you go. We're in some thermal. That's probably because it's reading our prop. Go ahead. And it said that we failed a flap, which is inconvenient. Yeah, X-Plane doesn't do reflex flaps, apparently. Alright, so this area that we're headed to, you can see the kind of canyon valley we were looking for. It's going to give us some lift. The general issue is that there are clouds in there, which makes me believe that that's going to go IFR real quickly. So let's go ahead and bust out ye artificial horizon. It'll be good. It'll be okay. Go ahead and pull back on power and just see what we can do here. Obviously, we'll be in some sink for a little bit, but we should get some lift when we follow through this canyon. Should take us right to the Grand Canyon. No, it won't. Don't follow this like it'll take you to the Grand Canyon. Originally, I was gonna do some flying in Colorado, but I was just trolling around trying to find good winds, and I found this. Good weather, and I found the winds out here were stupendous, and I was like, alright, well, we'll go gliding today. Seems like a doable thing. And we can go ahead and, I think, stow this. Do I want to stow it? I don't know if we should. I figured I only had about an hour, and if the gliding didn't go well, I'd get frustrated and just call it quits anyway, so I figured a gliding flight would be quick. And entertaining and slightly painless. So. Did I pick you up a McFlurry? I did indeed. And I brought it. Oh, I thought this plane had two seats. Well, that was awkward. Where'd we put your McFlurry? You know the water ballast? It's really our soft serve ballast, so we have a little bit of soft serve in there. Oh, snack! We just gotta get it there so you can have your snack, as John Fly likes to say. Oh dear! He's doing a John Fly impersonation. Oh dear! Oh, the delay is actually not that bad. The issue is I don't like this song. Not that has anything to do with the delay, but it does have something to do with the music I'm listening to while gliding. We just gotta make it over there, Kiwi. Apparently we left our engine up in Las Vegas, so we're gliding down from Mammoth. Alright, we'll be there in about 6 hours. Hills! Giant hills! Hills! Guess what that means for us? Lift is that way. Let's do it. Since we're headed to Vegas anyway, we can start making bad decisions early. And we'll go ahead and knock out the engine, head over there, gain some lift off these guys. We'll use the engine to get us here, and then we'll try and gain some lift off those guys over there. Alright. Go ahead and try and pull as much lift off this ridge as we can. This, although spinning, is generating no power for us. You can see that here. They're cautioning us about the cell temperature. That's fine. Motor's 14 degrees C, and battery temperature is 4 degrees C. It'll be fine. Batteries are freeze-proof. Because that just looks like a block of sadness and heartbreak. But over there are mountains. So let's head over to the mountains. I mean, this plane is like any X-plane plane, where if they don't do control loading, going left and right, you're going to get full deflection. So if you use common sense, right, and you don't deflect the controls fully while flying, then you'll be fine. I mean, the issue only comes when you go like this, but you would never be able to punch full rudder. So to me, that's fine. I'd rather know that I could pull full travel if I needed it than to be sitting here going, there's full rudder travel, and it's like, well, that's not realistic. And then as you lose speed, you start to tilt more and more. We keep breaking our flap, which isn't our flaps in reflex. Actually, our flap's not even in reflex. Oh, it is. Okay, there we go. Alright, let's gain some lift, boys. Let's go ahead and do it. Let's get all excited. Lift! Absolutely nothing. Tell you, if that isn't a bucket of bad news, I don't know what is. There's a little bit. There we go. Just come back around. Yep. Oh, we're still with our landing gear out, because if I were to put that up.
Stay on target. We're too close. Stay on target.
Stay on target. Thanks for the follow? Follow? Lost Kiwi? Oh, you with the host. I don't even know my own Twitch sounds. Thank you for the host, Lost Kiwi. It means a lot. And I hope you find your Kiwi soon. Huh. Huh. Fruit joke. Or is it a bird joke? Huh. Or is it a bird fruit joke? Don't worry. I'm working on a sound pad. And so then every time, like, let's say a user hosts me, or let's say, you know, Cat walks in, and I'm just talking about my pet, not Ty, I'll just say go, or, you know, like a host for each viewer who normally hosts me, who I'm on the auto host list for. That'd be hilariously annoying, and a hilariously good fun, I think, for everyone except for my viewing audience. I think for me, I'd really enjoy it, but my viewing audience would just absolutely hate it. And that's not what you want to do. You don't want to insult your viewing audience by playing sounds of people who host you. I mean, like, if John ever hosted me, which is probably not going to happen since I don't host John, I would have to get a John impression just for when John Fly gives me a host. Landing gear? We aren't landing. Now, there are hills that are alive with the sound. No, that's something else. There are hills that are alive with air over here, which makes me think we could get some lift on our way over to the Prosper Lands over there. So, yeah, that's up and stowed. Yep. Up and stowed. Up and stowed. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear. Up and stowed. Up and stowed. Still stowed. Up and stowed. Up and stowed. And now that we've positive lift, she doesn't care about our landing gear anymore. How rude of her. She only cares about our landing gear when we're descending, not when we're climbing. What happens if we're climbing up to meet the runway because we're below it? Betty won't care. She doesn't care about us that much. Lost Kiwi, as I said, that started that host. What do I use for weather? X-plane default weather and X-plane default clouds. I'm not running SkyMax. There's a lot riding on SkyMax, more than just the price tag for me. And I'm not running X-Enviro because I don't like the way the 2D clouds look now. And there are inconsistent performance things that I hear. Like someone asked earlier today, hey, I just updated to X-Plane 11 and now my X-Enviro, when I have X-Enviro on, my frames are lower. Someone else said, no, I'm still at the same frames. And so maybe it's just an optimization issue with what they've done with their X-Plane, or maybe it's the software. And really, I'm perfectly happy with the 57 frames that we have right now with snow, overcast, two layers of overcast clouds in different colors, snow and terrain. I'm absolutely fine with that, so we're going to keep that, and I think we're on the wrong side of the hill, because we're running up that hill. Cue the song! Cue the song. Now we're going to head down this way and get some more lift. Yeah, I know. And so when people complain about X-plane clouds, you can see we're running at 100% cloud puffs. Most people can't run at 100%. Well, that's a lie. That's a lie. Because when I updated to X-plane 10.51, my laptop would give me the same frames at 10% clouds versus 100% clouds. The frames wouldn't be any different. So they've clearly done some optimizing. We'll keep the oh dear motor out for the time being. They've clearly done some optimizing to their frames. I'm not liking this. Oh, there is lift. There is lift in these hills. Now we can keep going here, which I think might be a slightly good idea, is to keep going over here and just capture some of this lift, and then try these guys. Because right now, if we get into a bad situation, we're screwed if we're halfway there until we get to there, or until we get to turn around and fly back into the wind, which seems kind of counterproductive. So we'll see if we get monstrous amounts of lift. If we do, then we'll go ahead and go down there. If not, we'll go ahead and pick up some more altitude here. The only thing I wish with X-plane weather, default weather, is I could come in here and go, I want to fly 10:30 2 days ago. I had to get up and go to class or get up and go to work, and I didn't get to fly in this weather. And that's something that I think 11 can do, but I haven't looked into where I get the weather from. So then I have to find the weather, I have to find out how to find the weather, and then I have to download it and put it in the sim, which I hope is pretty easy. But I think, Nando, you might be able to correct me, but I think 11 supports historical weather if you can find the file to download. Yeah, and that's the thing, Super Donkey, right? Like, you have no issues, but there's someone else who had an issue. They posted it on the Pilot Edge Discord. And then someone else said, no, I don't have that issue at all in 11 or 10. And it was like, okay. All right, it's kind of... Alright, now we're just gonna climb up the hill here. We could do that thing Keith talked about. A long time ago, Keith talked about how glider pilots, or at least RC glider pilots, will take their plane up a hill and then drop it back down and then deploy flaps on the way back up to gain that lift. So I guess we can try that. Let's give it a shot. It's the worst that happens. Yeah. Well, that didn't go as planned. Not go as planned or as briefed. Alright, let's just keep doing this this circle here. Let the nose slouch down. And it'll come back up. Since we have like full flaps in, that's why we didn't hit a stall there. But if I didn't have any flaps in, we would have hit a stall. Because we didn't get to the base of the light arc there, but we would have been out of the green, and that would have been problematic. This side of the hill should give us something usable as well. Just go ahead and head over here. Obviously, we aren't going to be able to climb at the same rate as the hill because we don't have that much energy. We're right on the edge of a stall with flaps out. There we go. So we'll use this portion to gain the speed we need. Just let the plane naturally start to climb once we get a lot of airspeed in. We don't have a ball in oil, so we'll pretend we're coordinated. And here comes the speed again. We'll dust off some dirt from these trees. And we'll get slightly concerned. We're going to impact the mountain. But fear not, we understand what we're doing to some degree. I don't want to head perfectly perpendicular to the mountain. because that'll be the left side here. Oh, that's pretty looking. Bright yellow? You mean like this one? My favorite color? Which isn't really my favorite color? Foxtrot, Charlie, Victor, 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 Echo, Echo, Echo. Go ahead and turn towards it. Yeah, I mean, Kiwi, the whole issue with a glider purchase is you're paying $100,000 for an airframe without an engine. Which, if you paid $100,000 for an airframe with an engine, you could do a lot more with said airframe with engine. And while I think it's cool to buy a plane with advanced features, I can't imagine chucking $500,000 into a plane without an engine. When one, I mean, granted, in theory, you aren't limited range-wise. You can go as far as the winds will take you. But you are limited, because you can't fly through this, legally. You know, and it's like you're paying a whole bunch of money for something that limits you even more than if you spent less money and got a 172. And a 172 would fly the same. And so then it's how devoted are you to the airframe? For example, like helicopters. If you want to fly a helicopter, two things have to happen. You're rich or you do it as a job. Because you aren't going to fly a helicopter if you aren't rich or if you aren't doing it for a job because they're so expensive. So therefore, if you like the airframe, you have to be willing to put up a lot of money to fly it. And it's the same thing with a glider, in my book. Like, you really have to like this airframe. And granted, yes, you can go faster than a 172. Right now we're going faster than a 172, but you can't get from point A to point B. Like, you can't do a direct flight. Because you have to take into consideration where the winds are, the sides of the mountains you have to fly, and the amount of time it's going to take you to get up there. Like, I'm sure if any glider was pulled up to, I don't know, let's say 28,000 feet, it could glide to a lot of places. And they get some lift, and it'd be interesting to watch, because they have to wear oxygen masks and obviously find a way to stay warm. But you somehow have to get your expensive glider up there to give it the capability to fly directly to an airport. Which then means you have to pay the fuel of a tow plane that can go up that high to get you up there so you can fly direct to where you want to go. Oh, this is probably a bad idea. Screenshot. In the back. And we'll come back around. Well, that's the thing, right? I'm not saying, like, you have to be rolling in money all the time, Q. What I mean is, if you're a helicopter pilot, you have to have a lot of money to put forward to the airframe. That doesn't mean that you're going to have a lot of money yourself to use, because most of that rich money that you have is going into maintaining your helicopter airframe. So, whereas if you didn't have to buy a helicopter, you might be living in a 2,000 square foot house. You're stuck in a 500 square foot trailer, but you're flying a helicopter, right? And so it's all that priority. What are you putting first, the airframe or the money, right? So that's, I think we're saying the same thing. We're just saying that as a result of being a helicopter pilot, they're poor. That's because most of the money goes into the airframe. But then if you love the airframe, you're flying the airframe you love, so I don't know. I mean, I think in a perfect world, the best way to fly a helicopter is to get your license and fly a friend's helicopter, and then you're fine. Until your friend doesn't do maintenance on the helicopter, and then you're not too fine. Or you have a friend who feels like they can handle a helicopter that they aren't type rated in, and then you and your helicopter are not fine. I never heard what happened to that, Pendleton helicopter accident. Like, what the final word was on that, but whatever it was, it seemed like a sticky situation for all involved. Well, the two parties involved, it was no longer sticky for them, but the explanation as to how it happened seemed like it was going to be a sticky situation for sure. It says it can only glide 5 nautical miles. that's not too good. Let's go ahead and gain some more altitude here. Just keep flying around. Hello, X-Plane pilots. How you doing, sir? We're just doing a little bit of gliding around Mammoth area. We're actually headed south from Mammoth towards Bishop. KBIH, if you want to look at it on a sectional. The winds at Bishop aren't as good as they were at Mammoth. Mammoth was reporting winds 4-4 gusting 6-6, but they had... 4-1 gusting 6-6. But the issue is they have all these cloud things. And right now we're trying to find a way to Bishop that doesn't involve flying through cloud things. So we're sitting over here building our energy, in this case losing our energy, now building it, to fly back towards Bishop and hopefully punch through the clouds. This airport we see here, November Victor 27, other side of the mountains. So we would have to fly up and crest the mountains. Since we can't see the top of the mountains, I'm going to hedge a wild bet and say that we won't be able to make it over top of the mountains without going IFR. So that's what we're doing. Just kind of flying around. Tim P.E., thanks for the auto host. Greatly appreciated. I don't know if you'll get a little doo-ditty for it, but I appreciate it. And by doo-ditty, I mean that little Twitch alert that says, ooh, someone gave you the hosted. Well, it seems to me clouds are rolling in, which gives us two options. Run, hide. Those were the two options. You see how important sentence structure is? If I just said run, hide, you're like, okay, that's option one, what's option two? If I had said run and hide, then you're thinking that's option one, what's option two? If I had said option one, run, option two, hide, now you understand. That looks like a nice landing area. There's a little something road. Default X-Plane clouds, though. 60 frames a second. So that's handy. That's good news. Now, last time I checked, Bishop had ceilings of 11,000 feet. We're at 6,500-ish feet. So we should be fine. We should have been able to make it. We should be able to see the field. I have a feeling, though, that the storm is progressing, unfortunately, to the south. So let me go ahead and refresh our METARs here. 222-3902 Zulu. Okay. Yes, it is. That is bad news bears. Let's go ahead and head over here and take advantage of this lift. But, oh, I do have an artificial horizon, right? That's all an IFR plane needs is an artificial horizon and a pilot with a sense of direction. And a homing pigeon. That's all we need. It's just put a homing pigeon in here and like a constant stream of air, and whichever way they turn is the way that we turn. They'll keep us clear of one terrain, and two, they'll point us directly to where they came from. It's called homing pigeon navigation. Look it up, you'll find it doesn't exist. Let's go ahead and keep a turn going. That's what I'm afraid of. Because we don't have synthetic vision, how can we fly through these clouds, Kiwi? How can we do it? Let's go ahead and get our speed back. You'll see that this calculation is kind of rough. We should be able to make it if we go direct to... I don't know how to activate nearest, so we'll just type it in. B-I. And then we'll go over to H. And enter activate. How far is it to Bishop? Bishop is 9 miles. Let's go ahead and get some more lift. Might as well just hug these mountains and we should be fine. This will keep pointing us towards Bishop. Hopefully it should move the line as we move. If not, we can reactivate it a bit later. But that is pretty. I will say that. That right there, if I were to be like Catch Trader and copy what he does, where he gets a pretty image of the plane he's flying and puts a title over it, that's what I would use. And Coop, thanks for the auto host. And any idea of a bird to take from Long Beach to Montgomery? What sim? If you're going to be flying an X-plane and you don't really care about when you get there, I would say 195 or the de Havilland Beaver, just because I absolutely love those airframes. If you want to fly something more challenging, take the 407, do it VFR. I'm assuming you can do VFR based out my window. It looks like it's clearing a million in SoCal. So depart VFR from Long Beach and avoid all the airspace. Like, that's one of the fun things that I like to do on PE. It's kind of not what PE was designed for, but it's what you can use PE for example. You can test yourself and go, if I fly this route in the real world, assuming you have photo scenery or some way to accurately track roads, would you get into trouble? Now, back when I did it in the beginning, I used to ask the controller, you know, hey, just keep an eye on me, because it wasn't super busy, right? I'd be like, hey, you know, let me know if I bust an airspace. And my goal was to avoid an airspace at all costs. And just, or figure out ways to transition airspaces. You know, call before I intercepted their airspace so I could get through it. So like a Charlie, a Delta, whatever, fly through it. San Diego, Bravo. I've never done a transition there. I've seen videos of it done, and I was like, I should do that. But I never did. That's going to be sync, so let's float away from this ridge, actually. We have enough speed here. Let's go ahead and do a quick turn. Not bleed the speed. This is actually pretty pretty.
This is pretty pretty, man. Pretty pretty.
That's going to be dangerous. No, it won't. I lied. Why was I thinking that would be sync? I don't know. But this should be lift. And then we should be able to use this lift to climb over this hill. Problems? Big problems. That was a problem. That's why, because this would be sync. Let's see how far they think we can go. 5 nautical miles. That's because we're in a pocket of bad news bears, that's why. Check the current METAR for where we're headed, assuming I can click it, click it, click it. Wind speed, so it's just a wind speed increase. Wind speed went up to 2-1 gusting 31, not the 11 gusting 40 that it was, but... That's okay. Wind speed, wind direction has changed slightly to 300. We're coming from the north, so it'll give us, arriving from the north, so it will give us a good headwind, which is not really what I was hoping for. Go ahead and take advantage of this lift here, and we'll head over to Bishop. And that'll just be a quick gliding flight from 29 Palms to Bishop. And if you guys want to, maybe later tomorrow, that's going to be sync. I can hop into a plane with an engine that I would normally enjoy flying, and I can fly that same thing for you. And you'll be able to see how short of a flight that actually is. Well, are we still running real world weather? Because that... No. Why aren't you... I was like, this is terrible. Terrible conditions. What? Hold on a minute. There we go. I was like, holy, not good. That was a bad idea. That's better. Where's the wind? We have problems. That's what we need. It's gonna get vicious. Hold on tight. That was not comfortable for anyone. We're gonna need a bit more energy than that. Oh no. Oh no 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 no. Hmm. Here comes outer space. And that's how gliding can go horribly wrong. Now we're just gonna lull ourselves. Here we go. Here comes space. The final frontier. Ah. Hello, 40,000 feet. Oh, are we gonna go further out into space? Here we go. Prepare yourselves. Welcome to low Earth orbit. Oh, we're going down for more. Oh, maybe not. Look at the atmosphere. Isn't it just peaceful? Ah. Oh, sorry. Yeah, Montgomery. I would say... Yeah, I said Montgomery. I would say take a helicopter. But I can tell you what the good news is. I know that we don't like bad news. Ha! Who doesn't like them frames? Who doesn't like them frames? Alright, let's go ahead and center this camera back up. And I guess we'll have to debrief the happenings of that one. The good news is we're a signal for all the other glider pilots. It's like, yep, we've passed the yellow glider. There's the airport we were headed to. You can see that light. Ooh, double vision. You can see that light off in the distance, right by our wing, slightly behind our wing. That's where we were supposed to be going. Apparently not. Not from, well, from that altitude, yeah, from way up there. So let's go ahead and do Alt-R, Shift-4. And figure out where the issue was. The issue was me commanding weather update, but the real issue after that was me turning into a hill, I think, without enough lift. Okay. So this is when I realized things were going south. We came back from the wind update. We could have made it to Bishop. We honestly could have made it to Bishop. The issue was that these weren't realistic conditions that we were running before, and this is what we should have been seeing, which would have actually made getting over there more challenging. Because half the stuff didn't work. Is this even going to launch? Probably not, because we broke the plane. Yeah, broken. As I like to say, we borked it. Let's go ahead and continue through this replay here. So this is when we hit the weather update. Right there. So, the issue was here we got into a pocket of sync. I should have just headed direct for the airport. The issue was I was thinking, okay, now we have a headwind, which means that we probably aren't going to make it the 4 or 5 nautical miles to this airport right here. We'd probably make it to about that field, and that'd be great and all, but our real destination was Bishop. So, at this point, I'm trying to regain some lift that we lost, was finding absolutely nothing useful, getting dangerously close to terrain. There's a little bit of lift there. You can see how our plane kind of rose into the air. This might be a bit better. And then we just hit some sink. And then there was, I think, a little bit of saving grace right in here. You can see I'm kind of manipulating the pedals to try and get the wings into the wind. I bank us to turn in here. And here's where the problems start. Well, I see we have a little bit of lift. And then I'm just pulling us through a super tight loop. So that way we can come back and work this lift. And the issue is I should have just tossed in tons of power into this and just flown us out. Because if we look, we had enough charge to make it back from whence we came. I just didn't plan it well enough. I should have just used the oh dear motor and got us there. And I should have also turned away from the mountain and not into it. Also, for those of you guys who don't know what this means, we aren't coordinated in a turn, which is a huge thing for me in this plane because there's no ball in oil, and I'm not doing it in VR. But I should have been tossing in pedal. Anyway, we'll leave it in slow-mo. Goodbye. Our pilot's still there, though. He's still along for the ride. And then we wobble down the hill to our final resting place, we think. Nope. That is kind of cool, though. You make this little pendulum in the sky. And that's where we rest. Only a stone's throw away from our destination. And I should make a highlight of that. Anyway, I guess that'll do it for me. I have to go run some errands. I have to run mail out to a mail office before they close and no longer send packages out. But if you look, this is our total flight vector for today's flight. This is, when you see me circling around an area, this is why. You see how we're gaining altitude? And how I'm circling further out. I'm going to, like, the same point, almost. Here, I'll debrief this bit. Right, we're headed to the same point, but as I gain more altitude, we're headed back further. It's just super fun. This is that area where we did a tight circle, which actually looks like a circle, and then our flight path is over here somewhere, and continues, we can see the rest of it over here. Super fun to do gliding. I know it didn't sound like I was having a good time. That's just because I need some energy. And I thought gliding would give it to us. Sure enough, we had something interesting happen. But just a beautiful area in California. Even in the winter time, even when you can't see the terrain, it's just beautiful. Absolutely. Anyway, we'll probably leave it here. Because I got to go take care of some things. We'll probably hop in again, and I'll do this same flight. I'll just say, you know, quick VFR jaunt, and I'll show you how long this flight would take if you were flying your traditional GA plane or even a helicopter. That's what I'll do. We'll take a helicopter up either tomorrow or or sometime later tomorrow. So for the two or three people that are here, if you're free, maybe about this time tomorrow, we'll probably be doing something similar. Just a GA quick jaunt around, and then we might do some flying in SoCal. Anyway, guys. As always, I'm Flight Sci Tech, as always, inserted out here. Thank you very much for watching, and catch you guys on the flip side. And we'll have the music play us out, but I enjoyed it very much. You guys have a good one. Thanks for stopping by.